MedCram.com.
Welcome to another MedCram COVID-19 update. And in the United States, we continue to have this interesting situation where the daily new cases in the United States continues to rise, but the daily deaths are only rising minimally. Now, of course, that's diverse across the country. For instance, in Utah, daily new cases are definitely on the surge, and daily deaths are not commensurate with that. In California, daily new cases have actually plateaued somewhat, and daily new deaths are not on the rise. It's been 11 days since Hawaii opened up and opted out of a 14-day quarantine so long as there was a negative COVID-19 test. Daily deaths in Hawaii are also not on the increase. So today I want to talk about immunity, and in two facets. We'll talk about convalescent plasma, and we'll also talk about what's latest with the vaccines. So let's first talk about convalescent plasma. And as you know, convalescent plasma is currently FDA approved using an emergency use authorization to be used in COVID-19. Well, there's the results of a fairly large trial that's just come out of India and published in the British Medical Journal on convalescent plasma. And this is known as the PLACID trial. And of course, we will put the link to this article in the description below. And this was a multi-centered study that looked at 39 public and private hospitals across India. Patients had to be at least 18 years of age. So in this study, they took 464 patients and they randomized them to either receive convalescent plasma or placebo. Now, in this case, the convalescent plasma was 200 milliliters, and they did it twice, 24 hours apart. It was randomized, and as it turns out, 235 received the convalescent plasma, and 229 did not. When they looked at these patients, the patients that were enrolled had something called a PF ratio, P being the amount of oxygen and the F being the amount of oxygen that had to be given. So people with PF ratios that are higher are people that are less sick. So in this case, the patients to be enrolled in the study had to have a PF ratio of 2 to 300. Now normal is around 4 to 500, so these people were somewhat impaired. Now the endpoints were to either have a PF ratio of worsening, which would be around 100, or death. And that was the endpoint. And they wanted to see how many of these patients here and here actually went to a PF ratio of 100, which would be worse, or death. And at the end of the study, what they found was that those that got convalescent plasma had a 19% chance of reaching one of these two endpoints. And those in the placebo arm had an 18% chance. So it was actually lower in the placebo group, but the difference between 18 and 19% in this case was not statistically significant. And so they concluded that there was no difference in these patients, those who got convalescent plasma versus those that did not. Now, there was an editorial that went along with the publication in this British Medical Journal. And it was interesting to note what was mentioned here in this specific article. They did note that small beneficial effects were found for resolution of shortness of breath and fatigue. However, these results should be interpreted with caution because the trial was not blinded. So knowledge of treatment status could have influenced the reporting of subjective symptoms by patients who survived to day 7. The other interesting thing that they mentioned was that the primary hypothesized mechanism of benefit from convalescent plasma is through direct antiviral action of neutralizing antibodies on SARS-CoV-2 RNA. In this trial, the statistically significant 20% higher rate of conversion to a negative result for SARS-CoV-2 RNA occurred on day 7 among patients in the intervention arm. So in other words, the antibodies did what they were supposed to do. And they mentioned that here. Yet there was no net clinical benefit to patients. Why might this be the case? The next thing that they do is they describe the fact that when you give plasma, you can actually make the patient more hypercoagulable. And that's exactly the problem that we have in COVID-19. And so it very well could be that while the plasma is neutralizing the virus, it may be making the thrombotic nature of COVID-19 worse. And it looks like in this case, they left it up to the physicians to determine whether or not the complication was related to the plasma. And they may not have recognized that if there was a thrombotic event. They also bring up some interesting points that I believe are pretty important, and you can read those here in the editorial. So there's actually a counterbalance issue with convalescent plasma. Convalescent plasma, on one hand, has antibodies that will neutralize SARS-CoV-2, but on the other hand, convalescent plasma, by definition, also has clotting factors, and that can exacerbate the already increased tendency to clot in COVID-19. And as you can see here in the article, it says that immunoglobulin therapy, which is derived from whole plasma, is subject to a U.S. Food and Drug Administration warning about the risks of thrombosis, particularly in older patients, those with cardiovascular risk factors, and those with hypercoagulable conditions. Wouldn't it be great to be able to have the benefits of the immunoglobulins without the side effects of the clotting factors? Well, that's exactly what you would get with monoclonal antibodies. Monoclonal antibodies typically are synthetic antibodies that are produced and purified and given in isolation from these other thrombotic agents. So far, trials are underway testing out those monoclonal antibodies, and more data is going to be forthcoming. And what else is going to be forthcoming are the results on these vaccine trials, which are getting towards a foreseeable end here. The vaccine candidate from AstraZeneca and Johnson & Johnson have both restarted enrollment here in the United States after they were both briefly stopped because of some safety investigations that turned out to show that the concerns were not related to the vaccine. And of course, in trials of this magnitude, 30 to 60,000 people being enrolled in these studies, you're bound to have some things happening that's going to cause people to look and make sure that the vaccine isn't causing problems. And as we go forward, we at MedCram are going to do a deep dive on these vaccines and give you some information so that you'll be able to understand as these results come out and make decisions. Currently, we don't know data in terms of efficacy or safety. And so when they do come out, we'll need to have a context to put those in. And that's where we're going to help out. So watch for that in the future. Please come and see us at medcram.com for clear explanations on over 60 different medical topics. And if you're a medical professional, we offer CME and CE credits. Thanks for joining us.